Few fools, it's Matt, ESC United, your favorite Eurovision channel, and we're here a long day in Lisbon, Portugal, watching all the semifinal rehearsals, and right now we finished Moldova, Doredos, my lucky day, and call me crazy, but I feel like it may be the lucky day, see what I did there, but they had a very elaborate staging, and it's very difficult to even describe it. You have to watch that clip on YouTube just to see, but it's a big box with, you know, three doors, and then each door has three windows, and they utilize it in a way where they entertain us like a telenova, almost, we said. So I have to go to the guy on my right, Sean, first, and what did you think?
It's difficult to describe, but I'm going to have to describe
yes.
it. All I can say is, wow, it's... I don't give praise very easily, but this is genius. What they've done this year, obviously, Portugal set everyone a challenge to not use LED screens, and I think Moldova have really taken that to heart and gone, okay, let's do something different. Let's do something fun. The way that they stage this, I mean, I've not heard a press centre react like that for a song
in a while,
in a long time, and we have had some good performances like that this year, but it's fantastic. I mean, it suits the personality of the band perfectly. You know, it's got that sort of cheeky little fun vibe to it, the audience are going to absolutely lap this up. I think Moldova have come out of nowhere today with this performance, and I think they've really put themselves in contention for maybe a similar result to last year.
I think that's a bold prediction.
I think it's something that the juries and the televote will really go for. The televoters will love this.
Yes.
It will be very memorable. It's very inventive. And obviously their charisma and personality just shines through, and those are factors that will just, you know, it makes a memorable performance, and it's fun, and that's what people want to see.
I know, I completely agree. You kind of said everything that I wanted to say. It's
Sorry.
Really, no, that's fine. That's totally fine. Less for me to talk about. But I do believe that, and people are saying the song itself before was not necessarily a fan favorite, to say the least. Nobody talked about it. People are like, oh, it's like old school in Moldova that could have sent that 20 years ago. Yes, that may be true. But I feel as they reinvented that song. They really created something fresh by using something maybe familiar or dated, for the lack of a better word. I agree with you completely 100% about the staging. With all the, you know, they have the three backup singers who are basically the doppelgangers of them, like the duplicates of them, like wearing the same costumes, pretending that they're them behind the scene, all that stuff. And then they dance, and they were so flippin' creative. I mean, that team behind that is amazing. And when they came out the very first time, like the first rehearsal, they knew it, like they were completely comfortable. They were already in it. They have been rehearsing for probably every day since they won the national final, I think. And they were so spot on. It was mind-blowingly good to me. And I liked the song before, and now I am even more in love. This is going to be a feast. It will be remembered. And I don't know what else to say, so I'm just going to hand it over to Efe.
I'm gagged. I'm truly gagged. Like, I'm shooked. And it's just, you know, I'm shocked with Moldova's performance, because I don't know why, but again, my expectations was a little bit low, but this gave me life, you know. I mean, the telenovela thing, the theatrical thing, the vocals, well, the vocals are not that perfect, but, you know, everything totally, when you see the picture, totally, it was amazing. So, I don't know, I have to say, like, I feel like I have to say something more, but...
No, that's fine. If I don't force you, that's good.
Yeah.
So the question is, though, we got to be honest, what needs to improve? So the one few things I will say is, one thing is there were, and that's not even their fault per se, there were a bunch of microphone issues, not just the first run through, but several others, where the ladies were too loud and you couldn't barely hear the guys. Maybe it was the backup singers and it just didn't feel rich enough. But then at the very end, you might, like, all of a sudden when they cranked up the vocals, there was this big high note at the end, and they all, like, had this amazing harmonies.
That was really good.
So I think then that's a little bit working there, but do you think there's anything else they need to improve? But to me, it's like they don't even need to worry about the camera, where they could just put the camera on one the entire time, the 3 minutes on the box, and they're good to go.
But I think the camera work and the wide shots, they've picked the perfect times to go wide and perfect times to zoom in. You can tell they've been working on this for ages, because it is a really polished performance already. I would say the vocals is the only bit I could really pick on, but it's not like they're bad vocals. Mm-hmm. It's just that obviously they're energetic and they're moving around, so it is going to be a little bit shaky. But for this type of song, no one's going to care. I mean, it's, you know, it's not to say that it's a perfect performance, because nothing's perfect, but it is a really, you know, it's a really strong performance. And you know, people are just going to sit, and it's going to be must-see TV. People are going to watch this and go. Maybe some people will think it's cheesy and they won't get it, and they'll just go, "Oh, it's proper, you know, old-fashioned Eurovision." But so many people are going to love this, and especially families where they sit round of a Saturday night and watch the final. Because let's be honest, I'm going to answer the question now. Moldova are going to go through to the final. Mm-hmm. I guarantee you. They're not going to miss out on this one, and you can quote me on that. You know, people around Europe are going to be sitting around with their families and friends and things like that. They're going to sit and take notice of this, and they're going to enjoy it.
Yeah, no, I completely agree with that. So that's usually, I think it's almost unnecessary to ask that question, but I'll do it anyway. I have yours. Will this song qualify? We do our first gut feeling. This is just preliminary. This may change later down the road because, you know, we haven't seen all the performances. They all get to rehearse again. They may make changes, special effects, blah, blah, blah. So this is just a gut feeling, and then see if we're going to change our minds. You say, yes, it's going to qualify. Absolutely. Effa, is Moldova going to qualify?
Oh, yes.
Well, guess what I'm going to say? Yes. I mean, Moldova, I had it even before that. I thought it was an underappreciated song would qualify, and now I'm even more certain. So Moldova is going through. Mark our words right now. I bet my bottom dollar. And I don't have many bottom dollars.
Come back to this video after the semi-final.
And we'll say, hashtag told you so.
Yeah.
Yes.
Or we'll delete the video.
Either way, one of those two, right? Anyway, so but what do you think? We are big fans, as you can see. Do you think that we are overreacting and we're just getting distracted by a gimmick, if you will? Or do you think this is really something good and you agree? Watch the clip on YouTube on Eurovision's page and let us know. The comment section below, leave your thoughts, and we'll be back next. And the next country to rehearse is the Netherlands, if I'm not mistaken. So, yep, have a good night, everyone.